Здравствуйте! Доброе утро! Добрый день! Добро пожаловать на урок русского языка! Итак, как всегда, на уроке мы много работаем. Мы много говорим по-русски, много читаем по-русски и много пишем по-русски. Today, let us begin with a very short review of what we learned with you during our preceding lesson. And as you remember, we were talking about special modifiers and how they agree with nouns in number and gender. We worked with the modifiers этот, один, and this. Well, let's begin our review with этот. Этот. Итак, это газета. Эта газета очень интересная. Да? Этот журнал. Этот журнал очень интересный. Это письмо. Это письмо очень интересное. И эти газеты, журналы и письма. Ну, хорошо. So, the modifier этот has its masculine, feminine, neuter, and plural forms. Let's take a look at them. Итак, посмотрите, пожалуйста. Этот журнал, эта газета, это письмо, эти вещи. And you can clearly see your masculine, feminine, neuter, and plural forms of the modifier этот. We are talking about modifier, noun, agreement in number and gender. Ну, хорошо. Хорошо. Now, our second modifier was один. Один. Один час. Да? Одна минута. Одно письмо. So, let's look at the forms of the modifier один. Один час. Одна минута, одно письмо. And then you remember that the modifier один also has the plural form, which means only or alone. Один час, одна минута, одно письмо. And then одни. Хорошо, хорошо. Итак, у меня есть одна газета, один журнал и одно письмо. У меня есть одна ручка и один карандаш. Хорошо. And also during our previous lesson, we learned about the modifier this. Whole. Entire, or all, весь этот журнал, this whole magazine, весь этот журнал о России. This whole magazine is about Russia. Вся эта газета, this whole newspaper, вся эта газета о России. Now, let's take a look at the forms of the modifier весь. Итак, весь журнал, masculine, вся книга, все письмо, все вещи. Да? Весь, вся, все, все. Хорошо, хорошо. And you know that you can always find this material in your textbook in sections 11.1 and 11.2. А мы изучаем урок номер 11. Урок номер 11. Хорошо. А сейчас возьмите ручки или карандаши и давайте сделаем упражнение. Давайте сделаем это упражнение. Итак, посмотрите, пожалуйста. What I want you to do is translate these two sentences from English into Russian. Ну, хорошо. Хорошо. I hope that everybody is ready with your Russian version of these two sentences. Let's take a look at this. Итак, посмотрите, пожалуйста. This young man speaks French. Этот молодой человек. This young man. Этот молодой человек говорит по-французски. Человек, man, is a masculine noun. So we say, этот молодой человек, this young man. Этот молодой человек говорит по-французски. This young lady plays tennis well. Эта девушка, this young lady, девушка is feminine. So the modifier takes the feminine ending too. Эта девушка хорошо играет в теннис. This young lady plays tennis well. Эта девушка хорошо играет в теннис. Ну, хорошо. Молодцы. So now we can say this newspaper, this magazine, this movie, this TV show, this friend of mine, etc., etc. But we still are limited in terms of what we can express with these modifiers. Well, let's go ahead and solve this problem. Today we are going to learn how to use modifier noun phrases in the accusative case. So after today's lesson, you will be able to say in Russian, I read this book. Well, I know your brother. We saw our teacher at the theater. Please wait a minute. Or I read your entire letter. In these examples that I have just given you, the modifier noun phrases such as your brother, this entire letter, are in the accusative case. They appear as direct objects. Now, of course, our textbook is going to help us here quite a bit. So, please find section 11.3, and we are on page 196. Page 196, section 11.3, 11.3, the accusative case of special modifiers. And also, in your textbook, there is a very nice chart that gives you all the modifiers, all special modifiers and possessive modifiers in the accusative case. And now I want you to find it. We are on page 192 and page 193. At the bottom of page 192, find the sentence that says, Вот идет мой брат. And then there are several columns of phrases right under that sentence. So this is the chart that I'm talking about. This chart gives you the accusative modifiers. Okay, and now I want you to follow me very closely. Very closely. Again, look at this chart. We are studying the first column, and our first phrase is мой дом. Мой дом. What kind of noun is дом? It's masculine. But is it animate or inanimate? Inanimate. And what do we know about masculine inanimate nouns in the accusative case? Do they change? No, they don't change. They stay the same. And if a noun stays the same, the modifier doesn't change either. The modifier remains the same. Modifiers agree with nouns in number, gender, and case. Now there's a triple agreement. Number, gender, and case. And the general rule is, if a noun changes its form in the accusative case, then the modifier is going to change too. But if a noun stays the same, then the modifier will remain the same too. So, in the modifier-noun relationship, the noun leads and the modifier follows. So if a noun changes, the modifier has to change. If your noun stays the same, then the modifier stays the same as well. Now I want everybody to follow me very closely here. Again, we are working with masculine inanimate nouns and their modifiers. We are on this first column here. So, мой дом, твой дом, его дом, ее дом. And now we are on page 193. Наш дом, ваш дом, их дом, этот дом, один дом, весь дом. No change for masculine inanimate nouns and their modifiers. Журнал is another good example of a masculine inanimate noun. So, я читаю журнал. I'm reading this particular magazine. Я читаю этот журнал. Let's take a look at this sentence. Я читаю этот журнал. This phrase is in the accusative case, but nothing changed because this noun is a masculine inanimate noun and these nouns don't change. Я читаю этот журнал. Again, masculine inanimate nouns do not change in the accusative case and their modifiers remain the same. Хорошо. So everything is easy with masculine inanimate nouns since they do not change. But how about masculine animate nouns such as брат, друг, инженер, учитель, сосед? They do change, right? Remember, from the previous unit in the textbook, we learned that masculine animate nouns take the a ending in the accusative case. Брата, друга, инженера, учителя, соседа. And if a noun changes, then the modifier is going to change too. So let's take a look at this example. Мы знаем, we know, мы знаем этого инженера. We know this engineer. Инженера. In the accusative case, this noun received the I ending, and it means that the modifier has to undergo some change. It also changes its ending in the accusative case. Этого инженера. Мы знаем этого инженера. Now let's see what the textbook tells us. We are on the second column on page 192. Моего сына, that's how мой сын changes in the accusative case. Твоего сына, его сына, ее сына, нашего сына, we are now on page 193. Вашего сына, их сына, этого сына, одного сына. So for the modifier, the basic ending is ОГО. Од этого одного. Spelled ОГО, pronounced АВА. Одного сына. Этого сына. Okay. Masculine animate nouns change and the modifier changes as well. Хорошо. So we are done with masculine nouns and their modifiers in the accusative case. Well, let us move on and we will discuss feminine nouns. What happens to feminine nouns in the accusative case? Книга becomes книгу. Сестра turns into сестру. Feminine nouns change their endings from А to У. What's going to happen to their modifiers? They will have to change too. So let's take a look at this example. Мы уже знаем, we already know, мы уже знаем эту девушку. This entire phrase is in the accusative case. У for the noun, for this feminine noun, and у for the modifier. Isn't that nice and consistent? There are lots of rules in the Russian language, but rules work. Мы уже знаем эту девушку. And let's take a look what the textbook gives us. We are now studying the third column. Мою сестру. о мою книгу. Да? Твою сестру, твою книгу. Его сестру, его книгу. Ее сестру, ее книгу. And we continue on page 193. Also the third column. Нашу сестру, нашу книгу. Вашу сестру, вашу книгу. Их сестру, их книгу. Эту сестру, эту книгу. Одну сестру, одну книгу. Or всю книгу. Again, feminine nouns change and their modifiers also have to undergo a change. And the textbook gives you all these endings. Everything is summarized for you on pages 192, 193. You just have to know how to use this chart. Хорошо. And there's only one more category for us to study from the textbook, and that's neuter nouns. Do neuter nouns change in the accusative case? Письмо. Я читаю письмо. No, they stay the same. Neuter nouns stay the same. So what's going to happen to their modifiers? They will also stay the same. So let's take a look at this example. Я читаю это письмо. Я читаю это письмо. Neuter noun stays the same and its modifier doesn't change either. No change. No change for the neuter nouns and their modifiers. And again, back to the textbook. What do we have here? Моё письмо. Твоё письмо. Его письмо. Её письмо. See, everything remains the same. Наше письмо. Ваше письмо. Их письмо. Это письмо, одно письмо, все письмо. Neuter nouns and their modifiers remain the same. Хорошо. And now there's something that you will have to remember or write down, because it's not in the textbook. Plural inanimate nouns. Plural inanimate nouns, such as книги or журналы, письма, газеты. Plural inanimate nouns do not change either. So let's take a look at an example with a plural inanimate noun. Итак, посмотрите, пожалуйста. Я читаю эти книги и журналы. Книги и журналы are plural inanimate nouns. They do not change in the accusative case, and the modifier doesn't change either. So you always have to remember the rule that in the modifier-noun relationship, the noun is the boss, the noun is the leader. If the noun changes, then the modifier has to change. If the noun stays the same, the modifier stays the same too. But then when the noun changes, you need to know how to change it. And you also need to know how to change the modifier. That's why this chart on pages 192 and 193 is going to be so very important for you. And we'll be making a lot of exercises, we'll be doing a lot of exercises so that you can get used to this. But now let's go over the rule one more time. Modifiers and agree with nouns in number, gender and case. Triple agreement in number, gender and case. Masculine animate and feminine nouns and their modifiers change endings in the accusative case. Masculine animate nouns and feminine nouns and their modifiers change endings in the accusative case. And to see how exactly they change endings, you need to go over the chart on pages 192 and 193. No? Хорошо. Хорошо. We know all the rules, we know all the endings, or where to find them. Let's practice. Итак, это газета. Я читаю. I am reading this newspaper. Я читаю эту газету. Я читаю эту газету. Хорошо. Этот журнал. Я читаю этот журнал. Хорошо. Эта книга. Я читаю эту книгу. Я читаю эту книгу. Это письмо. Я читаю это письмо. Эти газеты и журналы. Я читаю эти газеты и журналы. Я с удовольствием читаю эти газеты и журналы. Хорошо. А сейчас возьмите ручки или карандаши и давайте сделаем упражнение.
I want you to very quickly put the following phrases into the accusative case. So write down the accusative case forms of these phrases.
Ну, хорошо, хорошо. Now that everybody is ready, let's go over this exercise. Our first phrase is этот дом. And in the accusative case, it stays the same. Because дом is a masculine inanimate noun. Этот дом. Мой друг changes to моего друга. Друг is a masculine inanimate noun. In the accusative case, it receives the I ending, and this is the accusative form of мой for those cases when it accompanies a masculine inanimate noun. Моего друга. Моего друга. Твоя сестра should change to твою сестру. The noun changed, the modifier changed. Твою сестру. Одна минута becomes одну минуту. Одну минуту. Feminine. And все письмо stays the same because письмо is a neuter noun and it doesn't change. Все письмо. So these are the accusative case forms. Этот дом моего друга, твою сестру, одну минуту, все письмо. Хорошо. And now that we know the accusative case of одна минута, 1 minute, we can learn how to say, please wait a minute. Let's take a look at this. Подождите одну минуту. Please wait a minute. A minute is in the accusative case here. Подождите одну минуту. Подождите одну минуту. The Russian people like to take advantage of of this wonderful ability of the Russian language to form new words by adding suffixes. And in most cases, instead of saying «подождите одну минуту», the Russian folks would say «подождите одну минуточку». Please wait one tiny little minute. «Минуточку» has a diminutive suffix on it. As if by adding a diminutive suffix on a word, you can shrink a minute. Подождите одну минуточку. Wait just one tiny little minute for me. Подождите одну минуточку. Well, this really does the trick because it makes the sound less imperative. You're pleading with someone instead of just telling them to wait. Подождите одну минуточку. Please wait a minute. Подождите одну минуточку. Хорошо. Хорошо. But there's one more exercise that I would like for you to do. You know, masculine inanimate nouns are sometimes difficult to handle, so I want you to take a minute and work on the accusative case forms of these phrases. Хорошо. Хорошо. This was excellent practice with masculine inanimate nouns in the accusative case. So let's take a look at the answers here. Мой папа in the accusative case changes to моего папу. You remember папа is a masculine noun with the I ending. А always changes to у. But the modifier has to show that it accompanies a masculine inanimate noun, so it has to carry the masculine ending. Моего папу. Моего папу. Now, дедушка is another example of the masculine noun that ends in у, in а. So in the accusative case, it becomes у. Его дедушку. And ее муж changes to ее мужа. Ее мужа. Ну, хорошо. So we'll be working with these nouns over and over again, and gradually it will become easy. Хорошо. So right after this lesson, I want you to pull out your additional exercises sheets and start working on those exercises. And at home, take a textbook on page 196, study section 11.3, and on pages 192 and 193, study the chart, go over the endings, and then on page 96, find the exercise 11.3, and work on sentences 1 through 10. Work on the first 10 sentences in exercise 11.3. You will be practicing with the accusative case of special modifiers. Ну, хорошо. Хорошо. Большое спасибо. I know this was a very difficult lesson, but we need to work on the difficult stuff too. Итак, большое спасибо и до свидания.
Здравствуйте! Доброе утро! Добрый день! Добро пожаловать на урок русского языка! Ну, хорошо! Давайте начнем работать! Let's get down to work!
Well, we have been studying about the modifier noun agreement. And you remember that modifiers and nouns agree in number, gender, and case. We learned how to use modifiers or modifier noun phrases in the accusative case.
And you remember that in the accusative case, if a noun changes, then the modifier changes too. If the noun stays the same, then the modifier remains the same. It doesn't change. So the noun leads and the modifier follows. So let's practice with these few objects that I have on my desk.
Итак, посмотрите, пожалуйста. Эта газета очень интересная. Каждый день я читаю эту газету. Я читаю эту газету. Этот журнал очень интересный. Я с удовольствием читаю этот журнал. А вот письмо. Я с удовольствием читала это письмо. Я с удовольствием читала это письмо. Я люблю читать газеты и журналы. Я читаю эти газеты и журналы. Ну, хорошо.
So you remember that in the accusative case, we have to be very careful with masculine inanimate numbers and feminine nouns because they change endings, right? Masculine inanimate nouns receive the I ending. Feminine nouns change their endings from I to O. So these two groups of nouns change their endings in the accusative case. And it means that their modifiers change their endings too. So let's take a look at this rule. Modifiers agree with nouns in number, gender, and case. Masculine inanimate and feminine nouns and their modifiers change endings in the accusative case. Хорошо. So, very quickly, let's go over different kinds of modifier noun phrases and we will review what happens to these phrases in the accusative case. Let's begin with this. Я читаю этот журнал. Этот журнал. Журнал is what kind of noun? Masculine inanimate. And masculine inanimate nouns do not change, so their modifiers remain the same. Этот журнал. Я читаю этот журнал. Хорошо. Let's take a look at our next example. Я читаю это письмо. And письмо is which gender? Neuter. And as you remember, neuter nouns do not change in the accusative case. So the modifier here stays the same. Это письмо. Я читаю это письмо. Хорошо. Let's look at the next one. Я читаю эти книги и журналы. Я читаю эти книги и журналы. Let's look at книги и журналы. What can we say about these nouns? Both of them are plural nouns, but are they animate or inanimate? Inanimate. Inanimate plural nouns. And you remember that these nouns don't change in the accusative case. So the modifier, again, doesn't have to change either. Эти книги и журналы. Я читаю эти книги и журналы. Хорошо. Now let us move on and look at this one. Мы знаем этого инженера. Инженер is a masculine inanimate noun. And you remember that in the accusative case, these nouns receive the I ending. Инженера. The noun changed and the modifier has to change too. Этого инженера. Masculine inanimate accusative. Мы знаем этого инженера. Хорошо. And let's look at one more example. Мы уже знаем
ту девушку. And девушка is a feminine noun, right? Young lady. Девушка is feminine, and it changed the ending to у, which means that the modifier that accompanies this noun will also have to change the ending. Эту девушку. Мы уже знаем эту девушку. So we have to be very careful with masculine animate nouns and feminine nouns and their modifiers when it comes to using them in the accusative case. And where can you find all the endings that you need to remember? In your textbook on pages 192 and 193, there's a nice chart that gives you all these modifier noun phrases. And you know, in the first column you find masculine inanimate nouns and their modifiers in the accusative case. Then in the second column we have examples with masculine animate nouns, then with feminine nouns, and in the fourth column here you have examples with neuter nouns. So please remember about that chart on pages 192 and 193. Ну хорошо, а сейчас давайте сделаем упражнение. Возьмите ручки или карандаши, и сейчас мы сделаем упражнение. We are practicing with the accusative forms of modifier noun phrases. So this is what I want you to do. I want you to write down the accusative forms of these phrases. Remember that you are working on these phrases in the accusative case. So very quickly write down these phrases. Ну, хорошо. Хорошо. So let's take a look at what happens to all of these phrases in the accusative case. Моя подруга. And the accusative form of this is мою подругу. Now remember, подруга is a feminine noun. It changes its ending to у, and the modifier has to change to мою подругу. Его брат changes to его брата. Брат is a masculine animate noun, so in the accusative case it receives the I ending. Его брата. Одна минута becomes одну минуту. Again, this is the feminine noun. This is a feminine noun in the accusative case, and the modifier has to change its ending to одну минуту. Этот профессор becomes этого профессора. This is a masculine animate noun, so in the accusative case it receives the I ending, and then the modifier changes its ending to этого профессора. And все письмо remains the same because письмо is a neuter noun and it doesn't change. Все письмо. So this is what you should have in your notebooks. Мою подругу, его брата, одну минуту, этого профессора, все письмо. Ну, хорошо. Хорошо. Again, keep working with that chart on pages 192 and 193 in your textbooks. In this exercise that we have just completed, we came across the phrase одну минуту. In the accusative case, одну минуту. And do you remember how we say wait a minute? Let's look at this. Подождите одну минуту. Now wait a minute. Подождите одну минуту. And you remember that instead of минуту, the Russian people always use, or very often use, a diminutive form of this word. Минуточку. Подождите одну минуточку. Минуточку has a diminutive suffix.
in it, and it makes this sound a little bit less imperative. Подождите одну минуточку, пожалуйста. Подождите, пожалуйста, одну минуточку. Please wait a minute for me. Подождите, пожалуйста, одну минуточку. Can you say that? Минуточку, минуточку. Подождите, пожалуйста, одну минуточку. Ну, хорошо, хорошо. All this material is summarized for you in section 11.3. And I did ask you to study that section, and I hope that you really did. Well, 11.3, the accusative case of special modifiers. We will move on to something else now, but we are not leaving accusative modifiers because we do use them for quite a few purposes. Our next topic for discussion is phrases that express duration of time. We are talking about phrases like for a long time, all evening, all Saturday, for 3 years, etc., etc. These phrases express the duration of time. They tell us how long a certain action or state lasted. And in our textbook, we are now looking at section 11.6, раздел 11.6. Мы изучаем урок номер 11, раздел, section, раздел 11.6. Remember, not so long ago, we talked about counting hours, minutes, and years. And now we are going to utilize all this knowledge. We will be using all this knowledge to express duration of time, to express how long something lasted. Let's take a look at these examples. Нина говорила по телефону 25 минут. Нина talked on the phone how long? 25 minutes. Нина говорила по телефону 25 минут. Максим смотрел телевизор how long? 2 часа. Максим смотрел телевизор 2 часа. So in each of these sentences, we have a phrase that expresses the duration of time. The amount of time that the action lasted. Nina talked on the phone for 25 minutes and Maxim watched television for 2 hours. Nina говорила по телефону 25 минут. Maxim смотрел телевизор 2 часа. When we need to find out how long a certain action or state lasted, we start with how long or how much time. Сколько времени? Сколько времени? How much time or how long? Сколько времени? Сколько времени Нина говорила по телефону? Or сколько времени Максим смотрел телевизор. Хорошо. Now listen carefully to my questions. Сколько времени вы читали этот журнал? Сколько времени вы делали уроки? Сколько времени вы смотрели телевизор? Сколько времени вы делали это упражнение? And if a certain action lasted a long time, then we just say долго, for a long time, долго, for a long time, долго. And isn't this nice that this Russian expression is so much shorter than the English phrase? Долго, for a long time. A while. And if a certain action lasted just for a very short amount of time, then we just say недолго. Недолго. We just put the negative prefix on долго. Недолго. Недолго. And say that one more time. Недолго. Недолго. Ну, хорошо. Хорошо. We can say Максим долго делал уроки. Нина долго говорила по телефону. Хорошо. Well, other phrases that also express the duration of time are all evening, all Saturday, all day, etc. Let's take a look at a few Russian sentences that contain this type of phrases. Let's begin with Мы отдыхали весь день. What are we saying? We rested for a whole day. Мы отдыхали весь день. And notice that we are using this modifier that we learned with you from unit number 11 in the textbook. Мы отдыхали весь день, the whole day, all day long. Мы отдыхали весь день. Хорошо. Let's take a look at this example. Папа читал газету все утро. Папа читал газету все утро. And утро is a neuter noun. Look at what happened to the modifier. Все утро. Папа читал газету все утро. And let's take a look at this. Мы отдыхали всю субботу. Мы отдыхали всю субботу. Now, what is happening here with всю субботу? Which case are we using to express the duration for this action? Субботу. The accusative case, that's right. Субота is a feminine noun. It changed its ending, to у in the accusative case, and the modifier changed the ending too. Всю субботу. So when we express the duration of time and we use phrases like весь день, все утро, всю субботу, все воскресенье, всю пятницу, which case are we using? The accusative case. Хорошо, so let's look at phrases that express the duration of time. Итак, посмотрите, пожалуйста. Весь вечер, все утро, всю субботу, одну минуту. And to express the duration of time for a certain action, we are using the accusative case. Весь вечер, все утро, всю субботу, одну минуту. Хорошо, хорошо. Let's look at section 11.6 in the textbook. Раздел 11.6. Let's go over the examples here. Сколько времени вы читали эту книгу? Недолго. Только 5 часов. А? Недолго. Только 5 часов. Да? Only 5 hours. It didn't take me a long time. Только 5 часов. Сколько времени Маша смотрела в окно? Сколько времени Маша смотрела в окно? Она смотрела в окно 10 минут. Хорошо. Мы работали всю субботу. And now we know that we are using the accusative case. to express the duration of time here. Всю субботу.
Хорошо.
Давайте сделаем упражнение. Давайте сделаем упражнение. Упражнение 11.6. Упражнение 11.6. Let's look at what we are supposed to do here. We should answer the questions using the phrases in parentheses. The first question is, вопрос номер один. Сколько времени вы гуляли в лесу? Let's take the first phrase in parentheses and compose our answer. Итак, мы гуляли в лесу. We walked in the woods. Мы гуляли в лесу 2 часа. Let's take the next phrase. 5 часов. So give me your answer with 5 часов. Мы гуляли в лесу 5 часов. Хорошо. Let's take весь вечер. Мы гуляли в лесу весь вечер. And let's use вся суббота. Мы гуляли в лесу всю субботу. Remember about the use of the accusative case to express duration of time? You have to change your endings here. Всю субботу. Мы гуляли в лесу всю субботу. So we have to be careful here. Ну, хорошо. А сейчас возьмите свои ручки или карандаши и давайте сделаем упражнение. I want you to very quickly translate these sentences from English into Russian. Хорошо. I hope that everybody is ready with the Russian version of these sentences. Let's go over it. John watched TV all evening.
Джон смотрел телевизор весь вечер. All evening.
Джон смотрел телевизор весь вечер. I worked on my homework for 2 hours.
Я делал уроки 2 часа.
Я делал уроки 2 часа. And you remember that wait a minute is подождите одну минуту. Or if you would like to sound more idiomatic, you would say минуточку.
Подождите одну минуточку.
But remember about using the accusative case to express the duration for this action. And since we're having a feminine noun here, we need to change the ending on the noun and on the modifier.
Подождите одну минуточку.
Ну, хорошо. Хорошо. Again, I need to remind you that this material is in section 11.3, that's the accusative case of special modifiers, and then the duration of time is in section 11.6. And we use the accusative case to express the duration of time when it comes to using phrases like all evening, all day, all morning, all Friday, etc., etc.
Хорошо.
And let's spend the remaining class time by reviewing the vocabulary of lesson 11. Let's look at this word.
Старинный. Как по-английски старинный? Старинный.
Ancient.
Старинный. Старинный город. Старинная музыка.
Хорошо. Let's look at this word.
Как по-английски современный? Современный.
Modern or contemporary.
Современный город. современная музыка. Современное искусство. Modern or contemporary.
Хорошо. Let's take a look at a few pictures. At a few pictures of different cities. And I want you to tell me whether they are ancient cities or modern, contemporary cities. So, let's begin with this.
Итак, скажите, пожалуйста, какой это город, старинный или современный?
Это старинный город.
А это, какой это город?
Это современный город.
Хорошо. Какой это город?
Это тоже современный город.
А это, какой это город?
Это старинный город.
Старинный город. Хорошо. А сейчас посмотрите на эту картинку.
Это Москва.
А? Это Москва.
Вы знаете, что Москва старинный город.
Но мы тоже знаем, что Москва современный город.
So it is possible for a city to be both старинный and современный at the same time. So let's read this sentence.
Москва старинный и современный город.
Read it out loud in your classrooms.
Хорошо. Москва – старинный и современный город. Давайте посмотрим на эту картинку. Это Новосибирск. Это город Новосибирск. Новосибирск – большой современный город.
So let's read the sentence about Новосибирск.
Новосибирск – большой современный город.
Хорошо, хорошо. So right after this lesson, please start working on your additional exercises and then at home, take your textbook, find урок номер 11 and on page 197, very thoroughly study section 11.6. On page 193, I want you to study the chart and the examples. And then on page 196, work on exercise 11.3 and your sentences are 11 through 20. So you will be finishing exercise 11.23.
Okay? Ну, хорошо. Хорошо. Сегодня мы много работали. И большое спасибо. До свидания.